Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late. And we have liftoff! According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato, I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Toridoris know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. Green Alien! At last you found him! He's wondering what took you so long. The Vamoosh is out of fuel. The power of the sun will take you back home. Welcome home. Good job. Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird. Well, there's Pocoyo and Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
You're drawing a picture today, are you, Pocoyo? How lovely. A picture of Pocoyo and his good friend Ellie. I'm sure Ellie would love to see that. It would be great, wouldn't it, if you could send it to her? If there was someone who could deliver it to Ellie for you, what you really need is someone who would like to be a postman for the day. But who around here would want to be a postman, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who might be our postman?
Pato the postman.
Yes. And something tells me he really, really wants the job. Well, you'd best be off. You've got a delivery to make, Pato the postman. And so, Pato is taking his first very important delivery to Ellie. It's a long way, isn't it, Pato? Pato, you've made your first delivery. Yes, how nice. And it looks like you're about to make your second delivery too. It's a letter from Ellie to Pocoyo. This whole postman idea certainly is fun, isn't it? Oh, Pocoyo, it is exciting to get a letter in return, isn't it? Well, you know, they do say the best way to get a letter is to send a letter. And the more you send... Pocoyo? Well, if you send that many letters, I'm sure you'll get lots in return. Oh, I don't think Pocoyo has any more letters today, Pato. He's got a parcel! Oh, no Ellie. Well, that is a very big parcel. I suppose it's for Pocoyo. Pato, that's too difficult even for an expert postman like yourself. I wonder what could be in such a large box. It's almost as big as Ellie. Even sounds like her. Another delivery for you, Pocoyo. What do you think's in the box, Pocoyo? Good idea, Pocoyo. We'll ask our friends. So, can any of you guess what's inside this gigantic box?
Ellie!
Why, it is Ellie herself! I bet the ears gave it away, didn't they? Oh dear, Pato seems to be rather angry. Oh look, Pato! I think there might be another delivery after all. Looks like a special delivery. Now who can it be for? Here's to Pato, a great postman and an even greater friend. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for Ellie! Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo. What have you got there? A letter. Wonderful. Now, if only you had a postman to deliver it. A postman! Fantastic! The postman says your letter is missing something. The stamp. You forgot the stamp.
Stamp!
Now, Postman Pato can deliver your letter. Can you tell Ellie what Pato is? And he's got a letter for you, Ellie. Ellie has something for Postman Pato, too. Uh-oh. Ellie's letter is missing something. Can you tell Ellie what she forgot?
A stamp!
She forgot a stamp.
That's one happy postman. Hi, Ellie.
Ellie! Search, Ellie!
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Sand! Receive!
Ellie is searching for send and receive. Caterpillar sends flowers. Baby bird receives the flowers. Baby bird sends a present. Caterpillar receives a present.
More!
Let's see more videos of send and receive.
Send. Receive. Send. Receive. Send. Receive. Thank you, Ellie.
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done. Oh, boy. Postman Pato is very busy today. What is that?
A letter! A letter for Caterpillar!
Oh, look! It's a parcel. A parcel for Fred. Ooh. Poor Button. There were too many letters and parcels.
Wheel of Colors.
Welcome to the show. Today's color is blue. Everyone look for something blue. Something blue. Let's see what you can find. All right, let's see your pictures. A blue pencil, a blue balloon, and a blue backpack. Good, keep searching for blue things. A blue door, perfect. A blue racket, excellent. And this, do you know what it is? Very good. Hooray for blue! Ellie says they're sorry for giving you so many letters and parcels, but could you please make one more tiny delivery? What a lot of parcels! Where is that music coming from?
From the parcel!
Look, Postman Pato, they're all for you! It's a party! How wonderful!
With a stamp.
Postman, postman.
Pato the postman.
Postman, postman.
This is a parcel.
Postman, postman.
A parcel with a stamp.
Postman, postman.
Pato the postman. Send a letter,
postman, postman,
which the postman delivers.
Postman, postman,
then your friend receives it.
Good morning, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone. How wonderful! But still no mother. You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes! Pocoyo takes care!
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Thank you.
Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Ellie, help Pocoyo.
Ellie? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Ellie, will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks? This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! You're a natural with these chicks. Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato! What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh! Their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hi.
I wonder who that is. Pato says that he's going on an aeroplane and that he forgot his suitcase. Pato says that he really, really needs his suitcase.
I bring.
I hope they make it. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. Ah, what's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was an ant who went to the beach.
I love the beach.
He took an aeroplane and a ship and a motorbike. But once he got there, he missed his friend. So he called his friend the dinosaur.
Friend, come play with me.
So the dinosaur took an aeroplane and a ship and a motorbike. And when he got to the beach, he and the ant had a fun time. The end. Running with a suitcase is hard, isn't it? Wonderful idea, Pocoyo.
Bus.
You can take the bus. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's the bus.
That's right. It's the bus. Now you'll get to the aeroplane much faster. Wonderful idea, Ellie. You can take a train. Can you tell Pocoyo and Ellie what that is? It's the train. Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 3 sandwiches. Very good.
3 sandwiches.
Oh dear. Well, how about 3 apples instead?
3 apples.
3 apples. Goodness, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
3 hearts.
That's right. 3.
Aeroplane!
Looks like Pato is still waiting for his suitcase. Ah, there it is! Just in time. Sunglasses? Uh-oh, Ellie's mad. She rode a bus and a train and ran to the aeroplane to bring you sunglasses? Pato says, don't be angry. Look, you're going on the aeroplane too. Traveling is fun, but traveling with friends is even better.
Travel on a train. If you fly on an aeroplane, always take your suitcase. Train. If you fly on an aeroplane. Always take your suitcase. Your suitcase.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pa. Sorry. Hello. What are you doing in that boat?
Fish.
Ah, I see. You're fishing.
Net.
You have a fishing net and a fishing rod.
Caterpillar.
And Caterpillar is going to help. Wonderful. Now we just have to wait.
Professor Toto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a ship. A ship. This is a boat. A boat. And this is a lighthouse. A lighthouse. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell baby bird what that is?
It's a lighthouse!
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Lighthouse!
Wonderful! Now we know about ships, boats and lighthouses. Thank you, Professor Pato!
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Can you tell Caterpillar what that is?
Fish! It's a fish!
That's right, it's a fish. Can you tell the fish what that is? Can you tell the fish what that is?
A fishing rod!
It's a fishing rod!
Look, boys! Pato's got something!
Pato! Fish!
A boot?
Fish, Pato, fish!
A wheel? Fishing can be very hard. Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ah. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 10 strawberries. Very good.
10 strawberries!
Oh dear. Well, how about 10 peas instead? Ten peas. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
10 hearts!
That's right, 10. Oh dear, you're not catching many fish. Oh, it's a big one! A very big one! Now, Pato and Pocoyo, you're not really angry, are you? After all, it was pretty funny. Hooray for fishing! And hooray for new friends!
I'm in a boat, I am fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net. With my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net.
Hello, Pato. Oh, I'm sorry. You'd like some peace and quiet, am I right? Well then, I'll be absolutely sure to... Ah. Right. Quiet. New mobile phone. It looks really cool. What do you plan to do with it? The first thing to do is to choose a good ringtone. Very catchy. It looks like you're not the only one who likes your ringtone, Pato. There, that's done it. Alone again. Ah, a nice, quiet stroll alone. It's Ellie calling. Oh, I see. Ellie called you because she wanted your phone to make that ringtone again. Well, I can't say I blame her. It's Pocoyo. He must want to hear that. Oh, Pato, do come back. That song is just so catchy. You've set your phone to vibrate, which means you won't be bothered by anyone anymore. I suppose that makes sense. Look, all your friends are here. Why don't you put your phone down and go join them? Pato! Your phone! No one's calling? That's strange. Oh. No one again? Then where's that buzzing sound coming from? Oh, it's just sleepy birds snoring. Looks like it was a false alarm. Oh, I'm sorry, Pato. All the cake is gone. But there are plenty of carrot sticks. Pato, what is that you're playing on your phone? Well, that seems fun. But wouldn't you have more fun playing with your friends? No, don't throw it in the lake. Pato, it looks like Fred needs your phone. That's all right, isn't it? Why, it looks like he ordered a pizza. And Ellie's texted all your friends. There's that catchy tune. Isn't it wonderful, Pato? A dance party with pizza. What fun! Goodbye, everybody!
Phew. Hi, Pato. Whew. It certainly is a hot summer day.
That's it, Pocoyo. Maybe it would be better just to go someplace cool, like the mountains.
The mountains.
Pato, I think you're the best choice to lead the expedition. Besides, you've certainly come very well prepared. You've reached the top at last. How wonderful! Pato, there you are! Finally! Better set up your tent, like Pocoyo and Nina. Oh, you found the tent poles. But those are golf clubs. I'm afraid you took the wrong bag, Pato. Don't worry. I'm sure Pocoyo and Nina will lend you a hand. Pato, a gift for you. Isn't it magical? What a wonderful camping trip this is after all. Good night, everyone. Oh, look, it's Pato. Hello, Pato. What have you got there? Soap? A brush? And a towel. What are you going to do with that? Oh, you're going to have a shower? Lovely. Oh, dear. What's this? Pato's soap, brush, and towel are gone. How is he going to have a shower now? A quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Shower cap?
Shower
cap! A doll? Oh.
Doll!
A phone.
Phone. Bye.
Phone!
Oh, dear. Good night. Does anyone see Pato's soap?
There it is!
There's the soap!
Good job! You found it! Does anyone see Pato's brush?
Ellie has it!
She has the brush!
Hmm. What is that on the scooter?
It's the towel! The towel!
The towel!
The towel!
Oh dear, Pato is really angry that you took his things. Now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, skip. That's it, skip. Fred says, clap hands. Come on, let's clap. That's it, clap. Fred says, spin! Spin! Well done! Fred says, that's all! Oh no, Pato's brush and soap. Pato, your soap is right here. Pato's ready for his brush. And ready for his towel. Hooray for showers! And hooray for towels!
I take a shower wearing my shower cup. I use the soap and then the brush. I take a shower wearing my shower cap. I use the soap and then the brush. And when I finish, I use the towel. And when I finish, then the phone rings.
Hello, Pato. Is that a racket? And a ball? What are you going to do with that?
Tennis!
What fun! It looks as if Caterpillar wants to play tennis too. Ellie says you're a little small to play tennis. And the winner is Pato! Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to the Olympics. so his friend the ant helped him train. He had to run. And swim. And bike. The dinosaur got very tired. But the ant said he had to keep going. So he had to run. And swim. And bike some more. And then... he won. The end. Ah, can you tell me what Ellie's holding?
It's a racket!
Yes, it's a racket. Fantastic. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a ball!
Ball!
Look out, caterpillar! Pato wins again. Shape shuffle. A triangle.
Triangle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
An oval.
Oval.
Triangle, rectangle, oval. What's this, Pocoyo?
Submarine!
I see. You've made a submarine with triangles, ovals, and rectangles.
Robot!
A robot! Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these? And these?
Rectangles!
They're rectangles!
And these?
Ovals!
Ovals!
Wonderful! Triangle, rectangle, oval. That was an exciting game! Who did that? Caterpillar? Oh my goodness! Just look at this! Caterpillar wins! I guess you don't have to be big to be a winner.
Tennis, I love this game. I hit the ball, I win a point using my racket. Tennis is a funny game. I hit the ball, I win a point. Let's play again.
Ball!
La, 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 la.
Racket!
La, 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 la. Tennis, I love this game. I hit the ball, I win a point using my racket. Tennis is a funny game. I hit the ball, I win a point because I love this game. Fabulous.
Hello, Pato. What are you doing? You're wearing pajamas you have a teddy bear and you're in bed. I see, you're going to sleep. Good night. Oh dear, what's that? Uh-oh. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. An alarm clock. A pillow? A toothbrush. Now, Pocoyo.
Toothbrush. Bye.
Toothbrush!
Well, good night. Pocoyo, it's not a good time to play. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato is wearing?
Pajamas!
Right, he's wearing pajamas. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato is holding?
A teddy bear!
Teddy bear!
Right. Can you tell Pocoyo what that is? Right! So, Pato is wearing pajamas. He has his teddy bear and he's in bed. What do you think he wants to do?
Sleep?
Exactly.
I'll stop playing! I put away. I put away. Meow!
Oh!
Meow! Meow!
Goodness!
Choo choo! I put away!
Oh dear! And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, jump! That's it! Jump, jump, jump! Jumping is fun! Oh dear. Fred says, clap! Come on! Clap! That's it! Clap! Clapping is fun! Fred says, run! That's it! Run! Run! Running is fun! Fred says, that's all! Are you going to bed too, Pocoyo? Now Pato can sleep.
Teddy bear!
That's Pato's teddy bear.
Good night.
Good night. Oh no! Poor Pato.
Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed with my pajamas and my teddy bear. I'll turn off the light to sleep well. Good night, my friends. Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed. I love the pillow that's under my head. Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed. I'll say goodnight to my friends.
Oh my, a pirate flag? Our friends seem different. They have a telescope. Pocoyo has an eye patch.
A map!
And they have a map. Oh, I see. They're pirates.
Treasure chest!
They're pirates looking for a treasure chest.
Piranhas!
Oh, they're piranhas. Be careful, Pirate Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to an island. He took a ship. But then, the ship started to sink. So he took a boat. But then the boat started to sink. So he started to swim. When he got to the island, he phoned his friend, the ant. He asked the ant to come to the island too. So the ant took a ship. But the ship started to sink. So the ant took a boat. But the boat started to sink. So the ant started to swim. When the ant got to the island, they made a lovely sandcastle and had lots of fun. The end. Our pirates are still looking for the treasure. I think Pato sees something. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato saw? Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato used to see the treasure chest?
The telescope!
He used the telescope!
What do you see, Pocoyo?
Treasure chest!
What is that?
Monster!
The treasure chest is guarded by a monster! How will our pirates ever get the treasure?
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is... orange! Everyone look for something orange! Something orange. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. An orange tent. An orange flag. An orange block. Good. Keep searching for orange things. A carrot. Yes, it's orange. An orange key. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is?
An orange alien.
An orange alien. Very good. Hooray for orange. Hooray, the pirates have landed. Oh, the piranhas are coming too. Uh-oh.
Treasure chest!
Oh no! The monster is awake! Run, Pocoyo, run! And the piranhas! Run, Pato, run! Oh dear! Phew! Now open the treasure chest! Oh! Can you tell me what that is?
A map!
It's another map!
Another treasure hunt! Ahoy, Pocoyo!
We are the great little pirates. We have a map and a telescope. We are the great little pirates. We're sailing the sea with our pirate flag. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope. In search of a treasure chest, we have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope.
Hello, everyone. Oh, and Pato. Hello. Oops. Oh dear, Pato, you do seem to be having a hard time keeping up. Oh no, Pato, I didn't mean that you're too young to keep up with the others. What's that? Oh, it's a pair of sunglasses, and very grown-up looking too. Is that how you wear sunglasses?
No!
Is that right?
No! No!
How about that?
No!
Is that how you wear sunglasses?
Yes!
You look very stylish and very grown up, Pato. What was that, Pato? You think you need a new name? Something that goes with your new style. Oh, I know. Mr. Waddles. How about Sir Quacks-a-Lot? No, Senor Shades. Oh, wait, I've got it. How about Mr. Big Duck? Pato wants to know if you like the name Mr. Big Duck.
Yes, we like it.
Yes, I think that's it. Mr. Big Duck. The perfect name for a very grown-up duck.
Pato, play.
I think what Mr. Big Duck is trying to say, Pocoyo, is that he's too grown up to play with blocks. Mr. Big Duck, why don't you show Pocoyo what a big grown-up you are? Oh, you want to be a grown-up too, Pocoyo?
Wow, you look very grown up, Pocoyo. Oops! Hello, baby bird. Wow. Look at these cool grown-ups. Yes, yes, baby bird, we know. You're a grown-up too. Well, here we are. All grown up. Yes, sirree. Three cool dudes. Oh, phew. Hello, Ellie. I think Ellie wants you to play. Oh, yes, I forgot. It seems Mr. Big Duck and the others are too grown up to play. What's this? Oh, look! Ellie's finger painting. What fun! Oh, it seems these three are too grown up for things like finger paints. Look, now Ellie's playing with building blocks, my favorite. Oh, lovely. Nothing better than playing with a splendid train set. Look, Mr. Big Duck, I know you're all grown up and everything, but don't you think you're taking this a little too far? Now, Mr. Big Duck, don't be upset. Pocoyo couldn't help himself. He's not really a grown-up. He's just pretending. Just like you. Oh, look, a ball. Why don't you play with... that's to say, bounce the ball. Don't worry, Mr. Big Duck. Grown-ups bounce balls too. What do you think? Do you think Pato should join his friends?
Yes, he should.
Hooray for Pato! Hooray for friends! And hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Bye.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Oh, what's this?
Duh.
Yes, I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out? To the sky? Now that's unusual.
Pato! Pato's sky, look!
Oh my! I wonder what happened to the sky? I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish.
What? Pato?
Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door.
Pato, there you are. Pocoyo is looking for you. Wait. Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him. Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again. Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him?
Pato?
Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Another door. More doors? Oh, dear. Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato.
Hooray! You found him. What's that, Ellie? You're working on something. What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Hello, Pato. Oh, what's that?
Scooter, scooter, scooter!
Whose is that lovely pink scooter?
Ellie's.
And I wonder what it's doing here. Perhaps she's forgotten it. What do you think? Should they take it back to her?
Yes! Take it to Ellie!
Take it to her!
Uh-oh.
work, Pato. You're quite the expert on the scooter. Looks like Pato is ready to show what an expert can do. Scooter, Pato. Wow! I like your caterpillar scooter, baby bird. Pato thinks you should stick to taking pictures of him, at least until you're bigger. Oh, my. That does look impressive. Whoa! Look at that! Oh, dear. I don't think Ellie's going to be happy about this. That's Ellie's scooter. Pato's having too much fun to remember. Oh, my goodness. Oh, no. That was Ellie's scooter, remember, Pato?
Ellie!
Oh, whatever are you going to do? You really think Ellie will like your sculpture as much as her scooter? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
Ellie's coming.
Pato, is that you? Hello, Ellie. Ellie, maybe you shouldn't get on your scooter just this minute. Oh, Ellie, up! Oh, dear. You see, Ellie, your scooter is, broken. They'll get it fixed. Don't worry. They tried their best. They did. You shouldn't hug them. You mean you're not angry that your scooter's broken? What's going on? Oh, I see. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Ellie has there? Yeah, right. And quite a fancy scooter at that. Oh, dear. All that worry for nothing. Hooray for Pocoyo. Hooray for telling the truth. Bye-bye. See you soon. Oh, look. It's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hello.
Oh, dear. They seem to be having a quarrel. What's this? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie what Baby Bird and Caterpillar are carrying?
Presents!
They're carrying presents!
That's right! They're presents! Today's Pato's birthday! Don't tell me you forgot!
Your fault!
Now, it's no one's fault! Let's just go and celebrate with the birthday boy!
Look!
Your friends certainly are excited about your birthday, Pato. And look, Baby Bird has a present for you. Flowers! How lovely! And look, Caterpillar has a present for you too. It's a stone. Wonderful. What a thoughtful gift, Caterpillar. Now, you two. At least Caterpillar thought to bring Pato a gift. What's that, Ellie? You have something for Pato too? Oh, I see. You're giving Pato a tea party for his birthday. And look, Pato, Pocoyo has a present for you as well. Oh no, Pato's new ball has popped. Oh, Ellie. Pocoyo, what are you doing? This? A cage?
Happy birthday!
Ellie, thank goodness you rescued Pato from that cage so he could really celebrate his birthday. Where's Pato? Pato is completely set solid.
Happy birthday!
This can't be much fun for Pato. Pocoyo, don't... Oh, dear. It looks as if Pato has finally had enough of your fighting.
Your fault.
Ellie, Pocoyo... They're really not listening. Perhaps we can get their attention if we all tell them to stop fighting. Ready?
Stop fighting!
Pato is leaving because of all your fighting. Why don't you both shake hands and make up?
Friends!
Now that's more like it. But you still have to keep Pato from leaving. Pato, you're not really going to leave us, are you? Oh, this is awful. Oh, Pato, please don't go. What will we do without you? Why? This isn't a going away bus for Pato. It's a birthday party bus.
Pato!
I think Pocoyo wants everyone to say happy birthday to Pato. Come on.
Happy birthday, Pato!
Hooray for birthdays! Bye-bye. See you soon.